Now we are narrating problem number 4 in assignment 2. The problem states that we have BX data register is composed of 2 bytes, low order byte and high order byte, low order BL and high order BH. Each of those bytes can be further decomposed into 2 nibbles in hexadecimal. Each nibble is 4 bits, as you know. So those 4 nibbles stored in the following order in BX: nibble 0, the least significant, then nibble 1, nibble 2, and nibble 3. So we need to write a program to reorder the nibbles of BX and store them in the new order in DX register. The order should be from low to high: nibble 2, then nibble 0, then nibble 3, and finally nibble 1. As the example shows here, so if BX originally have the value in hexa C6A3, so after the code, DX should carry AC36. Now let's go to the code and check how can we design it and how can we reach to a code that is working to perform this task.
The last problem in assignment number 2 is also kind of an easy bitwise problem. In that problem, as the problem explains, the BX data register is composed, this is a fact by the way, it's composed of 2 bytes, low order byte and high order byte. Each of those bytes can be even dissected into 2 nibbles, the high order and the low order nibbles. As we indicated maybe in an earlier lectures, that the nibble means 4 bits. Nibble means 4 bits. So I have here the 2 bytes of BX dissected into 4 nibbles. If I give, so this is actually the BX register. If I am to give an ID or a number for each of those nibbles, so I can simply call them, this is N for nibble, so nibble number 0, nibble number 1, nibble number 2, and nibble number 3. The problem is we simply want to demonstrate our ability to do more of a bit manipulation and utilize a very well-known concept called masking. Masking means I want to extract a group of bits out of a register or a memory location and separate it from the other bits or memory locations of a register or a memory. So actually, the program needs me to reorder those nibbles to store the content of BX in the register DX in a completely different order. So the problem needs that N2 comes here and N0 comes there and N3 to be here and N1 to go at the beginning or the first location here, N1. So it's kind of shuffling the ordering of the nibbles, the 4 bits, okay, of the BX into a different order in the BX register. There are definitely different ways to solve this problem. There is kind of a standard way to do it. Okay? Actually, you can come up with many other designs. I have here to manipulate 4 different pieces of information from BX. Correct. So I will go repeat a simple process 4 times. In this process, I'm doing the following. In step A, okay, I extract or mask or extract the nibble, particular one of the particular nibbles, the nibble from BX. Okay, we will learn how to do that. Then in step number two or B, I will displace or change the location of the nibble to the new location. In step number C, or the last one, I am merging or concatenating the nibble, the displaced nibble, into its destination domain BX. Okay, so we want to learn, so we will repeat this process. Then I can indicate here that this process really is repeated for the four nibbles. This process will be repeated for the four nibbles. Okay. What do I need in order to perform this? I have, in addition to the source BX and destination DX, I need a register to carry the the displacement, or I can do this just through an immediate value. Okay. Since the CX can be helpful in doing the shifting and the rotation process, so let us use the CX here as my counter to do the different displacements. In displacement, I will use the assistance of the CX. In the masking, I can use either a register or just an immediate value. Okay, depends on what I actually want to do. It makes no difference. Let's do it through just an immediate value. Okay, so now we need to initialize. Okay, first I wanted to initialize DX to have a to nullify it or clear it. Move in DX the value 000 in hexa. I'm just writing the numbers in hexa here to make it envisioned or visually more clear. But I can just populate it with zero. Okay. Then I need to go into those three steps for each. First, I want to extract the first nibble. How can I separate the first nibble of the N0 from BX? I have to do what we call the masking. Masking means ending the value of BX with an immediate value that has only ones at N0 and have zeros otherwise. So this can be and okay. Number something, I don't want to override. Because each time I want to extract it in this and I want to do that. So I use this now as And I want to use CX as the counter. This is definitely for step A. So I'm using CAX for step A. I'm using CX, the counter for the displacement. CX is the counter for displacement in A, in part or step number B. And the accumulation can be done right into A, into DX. DX originally have zeros, and I will just accumulate the nibbles that will be extracted. First, we need to initialize the or copy, okay, into AX. I will take a copy for DX. Now AX has a copy of DX. Then I want to mask. Step number A, masking. So I have to end AX with extracting the N0. How to extract N0? By ending AX with 000F in hex. This is, I did the masking. This is A for the masking. Step A for N0. Then, after that, I want to displace it. Okay, N0 should be come the next. So those 4 bits should be shifted for 4 bits. Okay, comes the next. So I have to shift to the left. AX. Before I do that, I want the counter. So the shifting here is shifting to the left with amount of 4. So I will move in CL the value 4 for the displacement. And I will shift to the left AX, CL. Those two steps are actually for the displacement. Now N0 is shifted to the second location. And then the last step is the merge. And this merging, since D have zeros, if I simply OR DX and AX, that means the content of AX will go to A, will go to DX. Or I can just making more. But right now, remember that I need, so if I just write those steps, and now I have in this, so here I have DX only 0, 0, 0, 0. Now I have an AX has after this masking has only N masking has only N 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 elsewhere. This is masking. And then in those steps, shifting, that this is actually the content of AX. Now AX has N0 going where? Into the second location through the shifting 4 places into the right. Okay. Now through this O-ring, I'm actually, this is step number 3, I have right now DX equals to 0 and 0, 0 and 0. Okay, so I place the N0 in its location. Then I will repeat this process again, all of those are for whom these are for n0. I want to repeat this for n1, n2, and n3. So for, again, move ax bx, refresh it, okay, with fresh copy of bx, and ax, and ax, in order to get an n1, 0, 0, f0. Then, okay, so here I added a, so right now, out of those two steps, step A, okay, now I have in AX, I have 0, N1, 0, 0 in AX. Great, masking. Okay, then after the masking, I will repeat here. N1 should go to the last nibble. So it should be shifted how many places? 4 and 4. So it should be shifted 8 places to the left. Yep, I have to move in CL the value 8. And shifting to the left, AX and CL. Those two instructions will do part B, which is actually placing in AX, we will place an N1 here, 0, 0, 0. Okay, the final step is the merge with the original value of DX, O-ring DX, comma AX will actually, this is actually step number C. Right now, this O-ring will actually, will do what? Dx has already N0 here, and 0 here, 0, 0, 0, 0 or N0, N0, 0 or 0 is 0, 0 or N1 is N1. So I have N0 and N1 placed in their correct places. Okay, now I will repeat one more time for you. This is the code for mean for N1. Repeated one more time, move AX, BX, and AX. I want to extract the nibbles 3, so 0, 0, F0, ending, and then I have to, again, this is A, this is part A. I have here, AX has N2, 0, 0, 0. Okay, then I have to move, I want to displace N2, should go to the first place. So it'd be shifted here, 4 and 4. So CL already have the value 8, okay? So, but right now, so there is no need for initialization, okay? I can just do the shifting. The shifting now to the left or to the right, this should go into that direction. That means I can go directly and a shifting to the right of AX, comma CL, which will actually, will do what? Will make AX 0, 0, 0, and 2. Okay, the last step is to OR DX and AX, which will effectively, will do, you know, this is B, and in C, I am just, now DX has originally N0 here, N1 here, and right now I have N2 here. Okay, the last one that I have to work with is the last nibble. Okay, again, move AX, DX, and mask, and AX, F0, 0, 0, 0 in hexa. Okay, and then move CL, the last one should be shifted 4 places, CL equals to 4, then I have to shift to the right AX and CL, okay, and the last instruction is simply to or DX and AX, which will effectively put the last nibble, okay, the last nibble, here is N2, here is N0, here is N3, and here is N1. Okay, so the nibbles have been reshuffled into DX at the last step here. Okay, agree? So this is problem number, the last problem in assignment 2. See you inshallah next time for assignment number 3.